the range is insane. Because we see Charlie and we see the characters in the opera in different places in their lives. So that means that it takes an emotional, acrobatic nature to it, that you have to leap from place to place, from relationship to relationship, from emotional status, from one scene to another. And that requires huge acting chops from everyone in the show. And so having two Charlies allows us to sort of explore different aspects of him in different times. And what it forces the other singers to do is to be alive at the moment.
Especially a role like this, it takes lots of concentration. And I think the older I get, I realize how important balance is in life, and a piece like this is a test of balance. It's a full thing, it's a full life. Charlie Parker was an entire person. He wasn't only impeccable technique, he was the bad, the ugly, and the beautiful as well. Yeah. So to capture that full human being, that full spirit, that is not an easy feat. You must balance, yes.
Charlie Parker never leaves the stage. And there are only a few minutes in the 90 minutes of uninterrupted music where he isn't singing. We never even get a moment to step out of character or step outside the drama. We have to stay fully engaged for 90 minutes straight. But luckily the story is compelling and interesting enough that it's not hard to stay engaged.
The reason we have two, besides the role being difficult, that's like just a logistical thing, it's the schedule. It happens in here in Atlanta every day. So that's the reason. You need at least one day free to not sing. That's why it's incredible. It's a remarkable cast because everyone else except Martin and I, it's only them. So they sing every day. And that's quite beautiful to see them work. And that takes another kind of balance and pacing and conditioning of the body and the voice and the mind to do something like this.
I've been fascinated by Charlie Parker really ever since I was a teenager. I've been listening to his music and reading about him, and I never imagined that there would be an opera about this man. And I lucked out that not only is there an opera written about him, but that the role of Charlie Parker happens to be a tenor. I would have been really excited to go and see some baritone sing Charlie Parker, but this is really sort of the it's almost too good to be true.
Charlie Parker was great. He was incredible. That's why we care about the music. We don't have to do any gimmicks for opera. Just make it good and it'll be fine. And we have to keep doing new operas. That's the key. Every opera was new at one point. We have to remember that.